family. I regret to inform you that I can no longer tolerate the cruel and unusual punishment that I've been subjected to endure under this roof. For over a decade now, I've been the victim of such inequitable measures, and I simply cannot stand to watch my rights be taken from me in such a manner as I have observed in this heinous household. By the time you read this, I will be gone. Through the cold and unyielding air, I will make the pilgrimage to my new home. Where that is, I am unsure. Yet, I am certain that any alternative would be a step up from the twisted, immoral principles that this household bases its adulterated justice system upon. Take this abnegation as a mark of my desperation, though in its extremity, I find it to be a necessary deed. Regards, Annie. Dear family, I'll have you know that I plan on having a long journey ahead of me. I'm going to board a ship on a voyage across the Atlantic, trying to get as far away from you all as possible. Maybe I'll go to Africa and happen upon an undiscovered species of animal on a wild safari. Maybe a mix of two different creatures, an amalgamation of sorts. It would be a vexing but wondrous creature, to say the least. Thank goodness I am departing at the time that I am, for my many ambitions would never have been pursued under your totalitarian grip. So again, I bid you adieu. I am free to change my mind, though, because I am no longer a slave of your caste system. I will become an artist. Yes, I will reside in Paris and spend my days drinking coffee out of small cups and smoking cigarettes and painting asymmetrical shapes on a canvas and call it art. On the other hand, perhaps my place isn't in Paris, but L.A. You won't hear from me for years until one day you see my name upon the silver screen and gaze at my fortune and fame. You'll marvel at me, grand and glorious, and be filled with jealousy over my lavish Hollywood lifestyle. Yet even then, I will still have not shown you a single sign of my exoneration. In fact, I will have probably long forgotten about all of you, and the only faint resemblance of a memory, including you, would lie within my artistic reflection of a dark and dismal past. Regards, Annie. Dear family, it has hardly been any time at all, and my journey has already proved tolling. Hazardous weather conditions will certainly be an obstacle, and perhaps detrimental to my health. Though I did pack accordingly, as any responsible adult would, I know that once my clothes wear, I will be left out, cold and hungry in the rain. Imagine me, huddling on the unforgiving pavement, dripping and alone. This is what will become of me. Does it make you happy? I know that this is what you've always wanted anyway. So when the pneumonia finally consumes me, and you gaze upon my beautiful, lifeless body, maybe then, maybe only then, will you be sorry. Signed, Annie. Dear family, I'll have you know that I've made temporary camp at the teepee you built me under the tree in the field behind the farm. I'm residing here because I'm left no other choice given the time I have before nightfall, but under different circumstances, I would have self-sufficiently found another form of shelter that A, was farther away from the house, and B, lacking such blatant cultural appropriation. One day I will live in a palace and wed a rich and handsome prince. Perhaps, though, upon seeing how poorly my family had treated me, he would take after your example and leave me at the royal altar. However, being the strong and independent woman I am, I would only logically proceed to become the democratically elected egalitarian president and legally exile all you elitists, as well as demolishing the monarchy. Until then, Annie. Dear family, it is now dusk. Approximately 24 minutes have passed since I left home. Though I cannot be entirely sure, I've lost track after all this time on my own. I've eaten the last of my provisions, and I'm now aware that the weaponry I've brought with me is unsuitable for hunting the wildlife native to this area. Years from now, though, when I'm a backcountry outlaw, these survival skills will do me well. I will be nothing less than a stone-cold killer, influenced, of course, by the cold-hearted people she was raised by in her early childhood years. Days will be long, nights will be longer, but with my stallion by my side and my pistol by my hip, I'll be unstoppable. For now, though, the struggle is inevitable. When I eventually reach civilization, the little money I have will not be substantial. I'll have to sell my organs. I have healthy ones to be harvested, and there are others in need of them. So yes, I will let them cut me open, a single tear streaming from my cheek as they reap a kidney, a liver, half my brain, who knows? And when I'm lying there, bedraggled and barely breathing on that cold, dirty, metallic operating table, maybe then you will regret driving me out. Until then, Annie. Dear family, I've been doing some thinking. Everyone deserves a second chance, and although I was hesitant at first to grant this unto you, I have now been graced with the maturity that I was previously lacking. I've come to the conclusion that yes, you are all only human, and yes, you are perfectly capable of making mistakes. I'm fully aware of my philanthropy, but your thanks is all I need, and I only ask for my return home to be event-free of commentary. The last thing I want to do is cause a scene. With love, Annie.